Good morning, guys. Two Tarantina over here. Does anybody watch her still? I wish she would make more videos. I really enjoyed her content. Anyway, good morning. I am ready to start my day off. Thank Jesus. A wonderful day off. It is a beautiful Sunday. And I'm on my way to get my nails done. It is only, you know, it's only been like 1,000 years since I've gotten my nails done. So let me give y'all a little bit of a background, okay? So I used to get acrylic nails ever since I was like in the second grade. And I'm not lying. Like, my mom always got acrylics, and I just always, that was like me and her's thing. Like, I always got acrylics. So I used to love getting like long, colorful tips. Like, I used to have pink tips, blue tips. I loved the tips. That was my thing. So I always grew up getting my nails done. And I used to have a very, very talented nail tech. Oh my God, I miss her so much. In Tennessee, I loved her. She did my nails exactly like, well, she always said what I liked, she didn't like, but whatever. Either way, she always did my nails so amazing, so cheap, so freaking cheap. And it was just the best ever. So After I left Tennessee, I really didn't know like who to go to, because I don't really like going to nail salons and just letting anybody on my nails, because like I just don't. And I like to know, like, I like nail techs, like actual people that do, you know, it's not really, I don't know how to explain it, but it's like, you know, nail salons, a lot of times it's just in and out. They just want in and out. I want people that like take appointments, like to take their time, really like to work on their craft. Like, that's what I really like. So I looked into, like, I was looking everywhere. If y'all follow me on Instagram, you know, I was getting upset because I was telling people, like, I was looking up the tags of like nail techs in my Instagram search bar. I was like, Miami nail tech. Literally everybody is everywhere but Miami. And I'm just like, bro. So it took me forever to find some place that was actually like, I like their nails, I like what they did and everything, and they were like close, or they were actually in Miami, you know. So I'm getting these nasty, ugly boy nails done. So freaking excited. Like, you guys don't understand. Do you know what it's like? These, ew, ugly. And now I like, I can actually get the nails that I want to, because I'm not working in a hair salon. So I don't have to wear, which I always had the nails that I wanted, but it was a thing in the nail salon. But like, I can get long, beautiful, luscious nails. And I can get designed the way I want them. I'm so excited to get my nails done. Nobody understands. So I'm gonna bring you guys along with me. I'm very eager to see like the pricing and how they do it and how they go about it and stuff, just because every place is different. So, because I know my nail tech lady, bro, she was, I felt bad because I felt like I was robbing her, because she would do them so cheap. She would spend so much time. She would do dip. She would put all this stuff, like all these designs. Her nail shapes were like bomb. And she would only charge me like $60, which I thought was cheap. I was talking to one of my new homegirls, and I was telling her, she was like, oh, how much did you pay for that? And I was like, oh, I think it was like $60 and like her tip. And she was like, oh no, baby, like I would never pay that much. And I was like, I thought that was cheap. So I don't know, we shall see. I don't have a problem, like I told y'all in one of my other videos, I don't have a problem spending money as long as I like it, you know what I'm saying? If it makes me happy, if it's fun to do, I don't care. I'll drop whatever. Like, cares? So that's what I'm on my way to go do. I'm so excited, and I'm gonna show y'all how it goes. Okay guys, so after literally 10,000 years, I have to tell y'all to get down when I get somewhere, but I'm starving. So I'm gonna go grab some food, and then I'm gonna tell y'all everything. I'm gonna show you guys. I found my new nail place. Let me tell you, I found it. I'm so happy. I can't wait to show y'all the nails. I'm so happy. I don't even want to put my hands on the screen because I want to show y'all. I'm so happy. You guys already know the vibes. You're in the steering wheel. But are we ready? Are we ready? I had to stop at Panera because I'm starving. So we're going to talk while I eat. But yo, actually, you can, ooh, right there. It's hitting. It's hitting. Ooh, la la. My grandma used to always say that. Anything, she'd be like, ooh, la la. But Jazz Beach. Do y'all see this? The shape, the design. I'm gonna put a better clip of the, like, my nails, but guys, I'm feeling like myself. Like, me and my sister were just talking about this because once upon a time, y'all, like, high school Samantha, the real me, not my personality in high school, but back in the day, I always had long pink nails. Like I told y'all, I always had my nails done, always baby pink, always. I never used to use, it would be a rare occasion that I would ever use any other color, but I would always have baby pink nails with designs, with crystals, with whatever. And because you know, obviously I love pink. Baby pink is just me. So just the straight hair, the pink nails, baby, I am feeling myself. I am in my, Jesus, I'm in my element, yo, like seriously. So we're gonna talk about the nail experience, everything, how much I paid, all that. I am so copying Stacy Diaz. I'm not really copying her just because I've always done this, like my nails and stuff, but just like the video, I guess the video idea, I don't know. I vlog anyway, but now I'm just talking about the nails. Anyway, so I was telling you guys, I was looking, should I just tell y'all what I'm eating first? I got a turkey bacon Bravo and a half of a Greek salad with chicken. Oh, I love the Greek salad from Panera. They are so good. So, guys, I haven't had nails in so long. I forgot what it was like to operate with them. Oh, but I just love the feelings. You don't understand. This makes me so happy. I just feel like myself. I feel like me again. Like my hair is long now. I just feel like myself. I'm telling you. It's such a nice feeling. My sister was like, she told me that Panera is just glorified hospital food, and ever since she told me that, I can't get that out of my head. Cause it low-key is. It's still overpriced. Guys, I'm pissed. I sat here and I was eating my salad and I dropped my freaking fork. I'm not done with my salad, man. I'm so mad. And usually I keep I usually keep like extra silverwares that I get in my car, but of course I'm out of those. I'm pissed. I mean, I ate most of the salad, but there's still some in here. I'm so mad. But anyway, let's take a break because I still have my sandwich left. Let's talk about my nail experience, how much it costs, how well, let me tell y'all. Okay, so I have been looking on Instagram forever because I really wanted a nail tech again. I was like, look, I got a job now. I can maintain these nails. Not only just like the money thing, but because, like, you know, we're opening back up, or maybe we're shutting back down. I don't know. But My last job, I couldn't really have nails like that just because they were really particular. They were really, like, you know, the most. So I didn't really get my nails done when I worked at the salon. And, you know, then quarantine happened and there was no reason to get your nails done. And now I'm just like, look, I'm at a job where really they don't care. I'm not doing nothing. And I don't have anything that's going to hinder me. Like, I'm on a computer. So, I'm, besides typing, I don't have anything that's hindering me from having nails. So, I was like, you know what? I'm finally going to do actual research and look up where I can get my nails done, who's the best, blah, blah, blah. Now, like I was telling y'all earlier, I am more of a nail tech kind of girl. I would much rather just have a designated person that does appointments rather than salons and stuff. The last lady that I went to, she worked in a salon, but I don't know. Nail salons are its own thing. But, like, she worked at a salon, but she did everything, like, herself. Like, she took her own appointments. She did stuff like that. She would kind of help sometimes in the salon, but her and another girl, they really were just appointment based because they had so much clients like that. So I was used to that. Now, when I was looking at places, this place came up. I don't know if I want to say their name. I think I'm gonna hold off on it. But I don't know, I guess. Whatever. I don't know. Let me get back to y'all on that. Let me just make sure it's okay. So, which I'm like, I'm thinking about, like, you know, obviously I want to promote their business. I don't know. Whatever. I don't know. So I went and I messaged him and I was like, hey, because it's my only day off until Thursday and I wanted to get them done today. So I was like, hey, I was wanting to know, because in their pictures, they have, like, who is the nail tech. So I didn't know who it was. So I was like, hey, is there any chance that I can get an appointment with so-and-so for a full set of long acrylics? And he was like, yeah, come in at 10:30. So I was like, perfect. I thought that was, you know, that I made my appointment. I was set to come in at 10:30, but we'll get to that. I go and I see a lady, and y'all know when it's either a hair appointment, nail appointment, whatever. Y'all know. So I got there at 10:15. There was a lady in the parking lot, and I was like, I know this lady is coming to get her nails done. I know for a fact she's coming to get her nails done. So I'm sitting in my car, she's sitting in her car. She gets out her car first and she's at the door. I'm not really like that. Like, I'm not gonna wait outside the door, but she waited outside the door. And so they open the door, whatever, or she was waiting for a little bit. Then two other girls pull up. So I'm like, it looks like I'm gonna be the one to stand outside the door too. So I get my stuff and I go outside the door. They open the door and I told the front desk person, I was like, hey, I'm here to see so-and-so at 10:30. I did not know. I was under the impression that I had an appointment. Like, I don't know. Whatever. So I was under the impression that I was coming to see that certain person at 10:30, whatever. And so they were taking other people, because other people were getting pedicures. And so the girl was like, okay, have a seat. She didn't say that the person that I was going to go see was already there, already had somebody, you know, because on Sundays they don't take appointments. It's walk-ins only. So I sat down, and one thing about my dad, he's always like, if I learned anything from that man, is that you never let nobody skip you in line. Like, that's it. You never, like, wait around, and you never let anybody skip you in line. So I was waiting, like, it was 10:20-ish, so I was like, I'm gonna wait till 10:30. If this lady doesn't tell me, like, who's supposed to be doing my nails or whatever it is, like, I'm gonna have to say something. So I sit down or whatever, and I'm thinking that, like, the person isn't, honestly, I thought it was a girl. So I was thinking that, like, she wasn't there yet or something. And so the front desk girl comes back, and I was like, hey, like, is the person not here or what? And she was like, I didn't say it like that. I said it nicer, but to speed up the process, I was like, is the person not here or what? And so she turns around and is the guy, like, in the front. And she was like, oh, he took her. The lady that was outside in the parking lot, the one that I should have waited in, whatever. So she was like, oh, he's finishing up her. And I was like, okay, well, can I just, like,
if she's getting her nose done, it's gonna be like an hour, right? So I was like, can I come back? Like, can I just come back when he gets done? And she was like, yeah, we'll call you, whatever. So I left. I went to go get something to drink because there was like a Starbucks and a Publix and stuff. So I went to go get something to drink, and then I come back and I see that it's like getting full. So I was like, actually, let me wait inside because nobody's cutting me. I don't care. So I wait inside or whatever. We make eye contact. We know each other. Well, we know each other. So like, you know, whatever. And so there was, let me set the scene for you guys. So it was the lady that was in front of me. We're going to call her Sundress because she was wearing a sundress. So it was Sundress, two teenage girls, and me. So Sundress went in first, the two teenage girls then, and then it was me. So the two teenage girls were going to get pedicures. So that's the whole other issue. That's their own thing. And then Sundress was with the guy that I wanted to get my nose done with. So that was us. I left, and then there was another lady that came in when I left to get a pedicure. So I left, I come back. Now it's Sundress, the two teenage girls, another lady, and two other ladies. Mind you, I had already set my appointment. They knew what I was there for. You know, we got the vibes, we knew what was up. So I'm sitting down or whatever, and then the lady, we're gonna call, like, I hope this makes sense. So everybody is just like in their spots or whatever. So these two older ladies come in after me, but they were already there when I came back. So the guy finished with Sundress, and so he was like, you could come on, like, I'll take you now. So then the lady, one of the older ladies, was like, no, I was here first. So I looked at her because I was like, I'm just gonna go sit down because this ain't got nothing to do with me. I know when I got here, you know. I'm one of those people, like, I will pay you dust until you address me. So go ahead, sit down, girl, because I'm going to go to the chair because I know what's up. So I go to the chair and I sit down, and she was like, no, like, she came in after me. And I didn't say anything. And he was like, no, she didn't, like, whatever. And so I guess that kind of calmed down, I guess. I don't really know. So because he started talking to me. This guy was so cool. He was like, what's your name? And I was like, Samantha. And he's like, oh, you were the one that I spoke to on Instagram. I was like, yes. So I showed him the nail shape that I wanted. I showed him the design that I wanted, and I just said, like, I just want baby pink nails. And I was like, whatever, like, I kind of want along this line, but I want pink nails. And so he's like, yeah, no problem. He starts getting the shape, like, he starts doing it or whatever, gluing the tips on, yada yada yada. Everything was cool. So I was like chilling or whatever, and he was like, oh, I think it would be prettier if, so I love this pink, this, okay, can y'all see that? I like this baby pink color. This is my favorite color ever. I don't know. Okay, that's my favorite color ever. I love this pink. And he brought out like more like hot pinks, Barbie pinks. And I was like, I don't want like my whole nail to be those colors. I just like the baby pink color. But then he was like, we could use hot pink and put the designs on them. I don't know if you can see that. I will also be inserting more clips, but hot pink to them. And I was like, okay, that's cool, like, do your thing. Like, I was like, as long as they're pink, I don't care. You can do whatever you want. You can do whatever design you want. You can, as long as they're pink, I don't care. So he's like, all right, cool. So he's doing his thing. We're having a good little chit chat. Like, I'm pretty quiet because I just like when people focus on like what they're doing, like, just focus on my nails, don't focus so much on me. So I'm just like watching YouTube videos, whatever. He's doing his thing. He's asking me periodically. He's like, oh, is this shape, is this length good, whatever, whatever. And I'm like, yes. I'm, you know, chilling, having, I love getting my nails done, it's so relaxing to me. So everything was fine. Then somebody else walks in the door, and they were wanting a pedicure. So there was like, you know how nail salons are, yo, like whatever, you know how nail salons are, where they have designated people for pedicures, designated people for like walk-ins, and designated people for like appointments and like acrylics, like stuff like this. So this lady walks in for a pedicure, and so they were like, they got somebody and she was gonna come back. That same lady is like, she comes up like, so I'm right here, she is coming right next to me but like hovering over me. So she was like, how long are you gonna take? Because, you know, you said it was gonna be 30 minutes. I came here before her. And he was like, ma'am, I told you, like, whenever I get done with her, then I'll do you. And then the receptionist lady, she also did nails. She was like, I already told you that I would take care of you. I'm the one that's gonna do your nails. I'm the one that's gonna take care of you. And then the guy that's doing my nails, and he was like, you said you didn't even want nails. And then you came back and said, because she was with somebody else, she was like, you said you didn't want nails, and then you came back and said you wanted it, so you need to wait. She was like, I said I didn't want it, and then I came back 5 minutes later. I came back immediately later so I could get my nails done. And he was like, well, she's gonna take care of you. And then she's like, but it's not fair. It's not fair. So at this point, I was like, okay, now this lady is about to address me, so I'm about to like shut it down, you know? So I pause my YouTube video, I take out my headphone, and I'm looking at her because I'm just like, at this point, lady, I was here before you. I was here at 10:30. You're coming over while I'm getting my nails done and arguing with my nail person, telling him that he needs to like, oh, like basically like telling him like he needs to hurry up because he needs to do her nails. Like, lady, I'm paying the same, if not more, than what you're going to be paying, okay? You just want regular polish, which, I mean, whatever, like, I don't care, whatever you want to do. But at the same time, like, lady, let's think business here. I have a person in my chair who's not problematic, who's going to be paying me more than you. Like, obviously I'm gonna be attentive to the person that is not being problematic and who's gonna pay me more. Like, oh my god, I can't with people. Like, I don't understand why hair salons and nail salons, people like to just show out. Like, what are you doing? So she was like, that's not fair, that's not fair. So I took my headphones out because I'm just like, this lady has one more time to interrupt my nail session before I get upset, because I'm chilling right now, but I'm getting mad. Like, don't do this with me, lady. Then the receptionist lady was like, okay, ma'am, like, you need to come over here because I'm gonna be the one taking care of you. So she said that again, and then I was able to finish my nails. He did such an amazing job. So other than that annoying lady, Jesus, the annoying lady that wanted him to just like rush my nails to do hers, like, what? Oh, so annoying. I can't deal with people like that. Like, why do you go places, especially knowing, because then like they called this lady called him and was like, oh, is there a lot of people? He's like, oh, I have two people that want to see me. And she was like, well, make an appointment for me. He was like, I don't make appointments on Sundays. Like, and she's like, well, you know, I always come to you. And he was like, well, I have two other people waiting for me. And I just like think about this because obviously I know what it's like to work in a salon, and I know exactly the people like this, but I feel like people get more like froggy when it comes to nail salons. I don't know why, but people get more intense when it comes to the nail salon. I don't know if I have a mosquito bite or what, but I'm just like, what is everybody's problem today? That's what I'm talking about. Yo, everybody here likes to fight, dude. And I'm just like, I thought it was so funny because those two teenagers, one of them was getting their nails done, like mine, except it was way longer and it was like really pretty, like this blue thing that she had going on. She was getting all types of design. Literally, her and her friend and that nail tech were unbothered. Nobody was bothering them. And I was like, of course I get the dude that like these people come up to him and just start going in, wanting him to rush so they could do their nails too. And I just don't understand the logic behind that, because I'm just like, girl, wouldn't you want, like, if I'm getting a service done by somebody, I'm gonna make sure that they're like so calm, they like me, like I'm cool with them, because they're more inclined to like take their time, want, like, do extra, like, hello, think a little bit. So that was so annoying. But anyway, so what I got done was I got, I guess this is a coffin, I don't know. It's like a mix between coffin and square shaped. I have long fingers. So I feel like, I don't know what it is, but I have long fingers and I like getting long nails to make them look longer. Is that weird? I don't know. But I got a square coffin shape, and then what he did was he used dip powder. So he did dip on, I don't know, because the way he did it was, like, instead of using acrylic, he used the dip powder. I didn't, like, actually dip my finger. He just did the dip powder, whatever. And he was just mixing the two between, like, light pink and the hot pink. And then he put some, like, he did a, what's it called? Like a foil. Is that what this is called? I'm sorry, I don't do nails. He did foil. Some foil right there. And then what I really like that he did, he put a clear acrylic on the, on these three nails. Well, these six nails, I guess. And it is, oh, I'm so in love. You see how even these nails are? And just how freaking beautiful. I just, I'm so excited. And then I ended up paying, so I personally thought it was cheap. I ended up paying $75 for a full set of dip acrylic design shape and gel overlay, because he did do a gel overlay, so it was shiny. So I ended up paying $75, which I thought was a good deal. I tipped him $20, so overall I spent $95 on this full set of nails, and I'd do it again because they're so freaking beautiful. Oh my god, I love them. I really do. And I'm really over here acting like I don't have a sandwich. I highly recommend the baking, what is it, the turkey bacon Bravo. It's really, really good. Well, I like it. But yeah guys, I don't know how I went this long without having my nails, but now, like, little things, I forgot how hard life was. Like, I remember I used to never roll the windows down because my nails wouldn't let me roll the windows back up, and I'm just like, wow, I have to go back to that lifestyle now. Like, no more picking up change, no more putting my windows down. I have to change my wallet because I can't grab my debit card. But I love it. It's a lifestyle that only few can understand. So anyway, I hope you guys like this video of my little nail experience. Let me know what you guys think. I'm telling you, I completely stole this idea, kind of, not really. I was inspired, let's put it that way. But anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope you guys have an amazing rest of your day, and I will see you in my next video. Bye. And try this sandwich.